What's good? What's good? This your host, Swag Boy, from SwagBoy360.com. Today's episode, dating coaches can be misleading. I got an email yesterday from one of my listeners who is also another listener of another dating coach, and he also listens to a lot of Red Pill and MGTOW content, but it's like he finds himself a little confused at times, you know what I'm saying? Because you niggas gotta be very like selective on who you listen to, you know what I'm saying? Now this particular person that emailed me, I'm not gonna say his name, I ain't gonna put it out there, because he did say he is a supporter of one of the guys channel, and he don't want the guy to hear that he said this to me, and you know what I mean, cause some friction. So I ain't gonna say your name, fam. I'm gonna leave it anonymous, you know what I'm saying? So basically he asked me, he said, Swag Boy, is it beta for me to cold approach? Because other dating coaches that I listen to says that it's beta and it's the opposite of being an alpha if you cold approach. Now check this out, y'all. I got into this before, but some niggas need to hear this, and a lot of you other young niggas need to hear this shit. Because the nigga that wrote me this shit, this a young nigga. This nigga 19 years old. And you got niggas in their 30s and their 40s telling niggas that's 18, 19, 20, 21 and up not the cold approach bitches. I got a problem with that shit. Cause I was 18 before. I was 19 before. You goddamn right I was cold approaching, nigga. Motherfucker, I'm cold approaching right now, goddammit. You know how many bitches I got from cold approaching? You know how many times I got some pussy from cold approaching? You know how many times I got my dick slobbed on? Slob like corn on the cob from cold approaching? Shit. Nigga, don't get me started. But no, before I get into that, let me just admit to something, all right? Let me just tell you niggas listening that us as dating coaches, we not perfect. You know what I mean? Like, we deal with a lot of personal shit in our personal lives that we don't disclose to the public and disclose to y'all. You know what I'm saying? For example, like, if you a nigga that be stressed out because your football team lost a game, don't come to me, because I can't help your motherfucking ass, nigga. Because I be stressing out over my motherfucking football team when we lose a motherfucking game. Like right now, I'm a Chicago Bears fan, nigga. We are 3-3, and it's pissing me the fuck off. It's to the point where when we lose a fucking football game, I shut down. I don't want to talk to nobody. I don't want to go out. Like, I don't want to do nothing. I'm so fucking furious right now at my motherfucking football team, yo. The only time I feel better is when I watch a Green Bay Packer game and I can root against those motherfuckers, man. The only thing that makes me feel better after the Chicago Bears lose is if I see Aaron Rodgers lose a game and he got a mad face on him. That's the only thing that makes me feel better is when the fucking Green Bay Packers lose, man. Like I got issues, nigga. When the Chicago Bears lost that motherfucking game earlier this year to the Philadelphia Eagles, when the fucking kicker kicked that fucking field goal and hit the goal post, oh, that shit pissed me off, man. I called the front office football team the next day, nigga. I demanded that nigga to be fired, yo. Yes, Swagboy360 called Hallis Hall in Illinois to have our kicker fired. I'm a fanatic, nigga. I'm so much of a fanatic, I don't give a fuck about no other team. I'm so much of a fanatic that when we lose, I don't want to hear about football to the next Sunday when we play again, nigga. So I'm saying that to say, if you niggas stressing over a game that y'all just lost, don't come to me for help, nigga, because I can't help you, nigga. I can't even help my damn self when it comes to that, because I'm stressing over my own fucking football team, nigga. But I can help you with these bitches. But I'm saying that to say, I'm admitting I can't help you with that. You know what I'm saying? So don't go to another nigga that got the same issues that you got for motherfucking help. See, a lot of you niggas have cold approach anxiety. Meaning, you niggas are scared to cold approach bitches. You niggas are nervous about cold approaching bitches. So then you go to another dating coach who's scared of cold approaching bitches. And basically, he's feeding your fear so you can be more fearful about cold approaching bitches. Now, when you come to me about cold approaching bitches, nigga, I'ma make you fear less about cold approaching bitches. Remember, I said fearless, not fearful, because these other dating coaches, they make you fearful about approaching bitches. God damn it, I'ma make you fearless. Come on now. Y'all niggas got, come on, somebody need to hear this. Somebody need to hear this. Like this one dating coach, he keep telling niggas, no man, don't holler at bitches. Don't go out and approach bitches. You gotta wait for a choosing signal. What nigga? Do you niggas realize how many submissive, shy bitches out here that are literally for you, that you're compatible with, and they won't give you a choosing signal until you approach them or until you say something to them? Do you niggas realize this shit? I hear this nigga saying this dumb shit. I also hear a lot of MGTOW niggas saying, yo, don't cold approach. Like, I'm actually like these niggas want these young niggas to suppress their sexual energy and desires and basically ignore them and act like they don't want to talk to a bitch. Like, it's only two times I could agree with a nigga not cold approaching or really not going out there hollering at bitches. That's number one, if you at work, don't cold approach. It ain't working, you know what I mean? If it's at your job, do not cold approach. And number two, if your dick don't work. Like, if your dick don't work, like, nigga, what the fuck you cold approaching the bitch for? It ain't like you can get the bitch to suck your dick. You can't fuck the bitch. Your dick ain't working, nigga. Like, you niggas don't realize how blessed you are to have a working penis, yo. Like, do you know how blessed you are to be able to walk or to wake up in the morning and have a hard dick? Do you know how blessed you are to be talking to a bitch and your dick get hard? Do you know how blessed you are to be, like, having foreplay with a bitch, you kissing a bitch and your dick getting hard? Like, do you know how blessed you are to have and maintain a erection on your own? Do you know how, nigga, that is a motherfucking blessing, nigga. If you don't believe that's a blessing, talk to a older nigga that's in his 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s, and he need a fucking pill to get an erection. Or in some cases, unfortunately, niggas can't even get an erection even with that pill, nigga. That's how blessed you are, nigga. Don't you know what those unhealthy men would do to have your testosterone, to have your libido, to have your energy to fuck a bitch, to have your health to the point where they can maintain an erection to pound a bitch? Don't you know what them niggas will give to have an erection so they could put they dick in a bitch mouth, nigga? Do you understand this shit? And here it is, you got these MGTOW niggas, you got these punk ass red pill niggas telling you it's unalpha, it's beta for you to walk up to a bitch and talk to her. That's some sucker shit. I got a problem with them niggas, son. Straight up, got a problem with them niggas. Let me break this shit down, son. Because, yo, y'all niggas heard that fucking that rap song with Kodak Black. He was like, these motherfuckers don't wanna see you winning. They wanna see you end up in a tantrum. Y'all remember that song, right? That's how I feel about these dating coaches who be telling niggas not to cold approach, yo. These dating coaches don't wanna see you winning. Or better yet, these dating coaches don't wanna see. These dating coaches don't wanna see you fucking. I want to see you niggas fucking, especially my young niggas, my 18-year-old niggas, 19, 20, 21, all my college niggas. I want to see you niggas fucking these bitches, man. But these dating coaches tell you not to cold approach. These niggas don't want to see you fucking. They want to see you jerking off, nigga. It is like this. These dating coaches don't want to see you fucking. These motherfuckers want to see you jerking. I ain't with that shit. Nah, son. I ain't with that shit, son. I want to see my young niggas fucking these bitches, man. Matter of fact, I want to see all my niggas fucking these bitches, man. Fuck what these dating coaches saying. Talk about don't cold approach these bitches. Let me tell you what's going to happen. Because this is what happened to me, right? When I used, back in the day, long time ago, when I used to be a little nervous about cold approaching bitches, I used to see sexy, cute bitches, right? A sexy, cute bitch. I'm like, damn, she cute. But I was too scared to cold approach. Then I saw like a little nerd ass nigga approach her. Next thing you know, this bitch acting all bubbly and cool. I'm like, damn, yo. She a cute bitch and she a cool bitch. I should have hollered at her, but it was too late. But when I saw that, I learned from that. I said, you know what? I'm going to start capitalizing off of that. Next time when I see a cute bitch, I'm going to start talking to that bitch. And that's what I started doing, nigga. Yeah, sometimes a bitch going to say no. Let me tell you something, fellas. When you cold approaching out here, every bitch ain't going to be feeling you. Yeah, every now and then you might come across a disrespectful ass bitch. You know what I'm saying? That want to be disrespectful, want to be bitchy. But just leave them bitches alone, son. Don't let one stupid, disrespectful bitch cause you niggas not to cold approach other bitches that you could be compatible with, nigga. Because let me tell you this, nigga. You do that, nigga, you gonna miss out on a lot of good pussy and a lot of good blowjobs. You do that shit, nigga. And the thing with me, like, I don't understand how people could downplay cold approaching, because especially with young men, like with me, cold approaching had a lot to do with me evolving into a man, yo. You know what I mean? Because like in my hood, we ain't call it cold approaching. Like cold approach is like the terminology we use on YouTube and the internet. But we called it like pushing up on a bitch, hollering at a bitch. You know what I mean? Like when we out in the hood, we out and about, we at a party, we see a cute bitch, niggas like, yo, push up, yo. Holla at her, holla at her. And that's what we did, yo. We ain't sit back in the cut, be like, nah, man, I'ma wait for her to send me choosing signals and all that, man. And yo, and when you holler at some of these bitches, a lot of these bitches will be kind of thankful and like the fact that you was talking to them, man. Like some of these niggas, like, cause they be like, some of these niggas don't got the balls to approach bitches, man. And here it is, you got the balls to approach a bitch. Now, that bitch could take a liking to you, man. So, like, don't listen to these dating coaches telling you not to cold approach bitches, man. Because what happened is that they projecting the fear that they have within themselves upon you, man. Don't do that. Just like, I can't tell you how to stop stressing over your football team losing, because I'm dealing with that shit. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta go to those who can help you, nigga. You know what I'm saying? But you can come to me when you stressing over a bitch. I could tell you how to relieve yourself from stressing over a bitch, and I could also tell you how to prevent that in the motherfucking future, nigga. Because I want to see you winning, nigga. I want to see you fucking. I don't want to see you jerking, nigga. I don't want to hear about, oh, it's a Friday night, Saturday night. I'm in the house jerking off. No, fuck that, man. I want you young niggas be out here fucking these bitches, man. I want you niggas out here getting top from these bitches, not paying for it. You know what I'm saying? Remember, I don't want you paying for that shit, nigga. I want you getting your dick sucked and fucking bitches that really fucking with you, that's really feeling your swag, nigga. Cause like me, like sometimes I be around older niggas, man. And yo, you think older niggas, like, they don't think about fucking these bitches? Nigga, older niggas is fucking freaks too, nigga. Like, these niggas be wanting to fuck bitches. But they always say, you know what, oh, when I'm around some older niggas, yo, they be like, damn, man, if I could have caught her 30 years ago, ooh, she would have been mine, nigga. But that's y'all right now. I mean, right now, 30 years ago, right now, like he was y'all 30 years ago, 20 years ago, 40 years ago, and y'all ain't cold approaching. Y'all basically letting your youth go to waste, nigga. Cause Sheik Luke said it, nigga. You gonna be older way longer than you gonna be younger. So with that being said, why not capitalize off the advantage that you have now, man? Some of you young niggas are strong, man. You got a healthy working penis, nigga. You niggas in y'all teens, y'all 20s, y'all 30s, y'all 40s, still letting this pussy just walk right by y'all niggas. And then y'all be wishing, oh, I should have talked to her. I should have talked to her, because I'm tired of you fucking MGTOW niggas trying to get these other niggas to suppress their sexual feelings, nigga. No, nigga, it's good to get your dick sucked and bust a load in the bitch mouth. It's good to skeet on these bitches. It's good to bend a bitch over and get that bitch back shots, nigga. That's man shit right there, nigga. You got these niggas talking about, you gotta wait till she give you choosing signals. Fuck that shit, yo. You niggas keep listening to them niggas. Keep listening to them niggas. And you niggas gonna despise them niggas, man. When you niggas want pussy, and now you can't get it, not because you ugly, not because you broke, not because you don't have the confidence, it's because you listen to the wrong motherfuckers. That's why, nigga. And you gonna be mad at them niggas. Matter of fact, you gonna be mad at yourself for listening to them motherfuckers, man. You know what? I'm about to close out, but look, let me close out with giving y'all some code approaching game, man. Alright? When I code approach bitches, I approach them with a question. So, like I said, if she a black bitch, you know what I mean? I code approach black bitch like, yo, ask if they got some motherfucking lotion. Most black bitches got lotion on them, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, it was good, ma. You got some lotion? Like, lotion? Yeah, like, you got some lotion? My hand's a little ashy. I know you got some cocoa butt up in there, girl. You know what I'm saying? So, I start out with that, you know what I mean? Most black bitches got some lotion, you know what I mean? If let's say they be like, no, I don't got no lotion, they keep it moving. Then that's it. You just let them go. You gotta start off with a question to fill off their to evaluate their body language. You know what I mean? That's how you code approach. You code approach by asking a question. You know what I'm saying? With my white bitches and other bitches, I'll be like, I ask for directions. I'll be like, hey yo, you know how to get to such and such street? White bitch like, oh yeah, sure, you just make it right over there and make a left over there and you're right there. Like, oh shit, good looking, ma. What's your name, by the way? Oh, I'm Megan. Bitch be all goofy laughing and shit. I'm like, that's what's up, yo, Megan, good looking. You seem cool, me get that number, yo. Oh sure, yeah, maybe we can hang out, get some Starbucks. Just like that. And then if you do open up with a question and she don't give you the body language you looking for, just keep it moving. Cause sometimes I holler at a bitch, she don't give me the body language I'm looking for. I be like, yo, you know how to get to such and such street? They be like, nope, and they just keep it moving. And I fall back. So right there, I just gave you niggas quick game on how to code approach, man. You open up with a basic question, and then you see what her body language is like. Once you see what her body language is like, that's your cue to either quit right there or continue, go further, and close the motherfucking deal, nigga. In closing, stop being scared to code approach these bitches, nigga. Cause Swagboy 360 from Swagboy360.com, I wanna see you niggas winning, nigga. I wanna see you niggas fucking these bitches. I wanna see you niggas getting your dick sucked by these hoes out here, nigga. Stop listening to these other suck ass niggas that scared to approach these bitches, cause they ain't about that life. And if to all you other dating coaches that's out here telling these young niggas stop cold approaching and stop hollering at bitches because it's beta, nah, nigga, you the real fucking beta, nigga, because your punk ass cannot overcome your fear. Boom! That was today's episode. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'ma catch you on the next go round.